way. So if I say something and you say, no, that's not true, I know it differently, I apologize. I prepared a PowerPoint for you to help you visualize what we're going to be speaking about. As a kid, all I remember is lighting the Hanukkah menorah with my family, spinning the dreidel, and eating latkes. Jelly donuts weren't even a thing back then. Till, who remembers that? Who remembers a jelly donut from when they were kids? Not Dunkin'. You remember jelly donuts when you were a kid? Okay, so let's get to some interesting facts. I'm going to get to some facts about how Hanukkah came around. Hanukkah means dedication. This is a holiday that the temple was rededicated. And I'll go over some things. I hope you won't find it too boring. There's a lot of stuff involved here. But the first thing I have to say is, do you see how it's spelled over here?
Yes.
Do you know other spellings of this word? We really don't know how to spell it.
Good.
To be honest, we really don't. And also, when we say Hanukkah, we say Hanukkiah, which is the menorah that we light. But just to show you what a menorah was, given to us the description in the Bible of Exodus, the Exodus book,
is this. This only has six, and this is the seventh.
There are different descriptions and understandings of why that six of one, 7 days of creation, makes sense. Maybe, I don't know. A menorah came around for the Hanukkah, for the eight candles. I will talk about the miracle. It's also considered the holiday of light. We shine our light on other people. So I just want to read to you something. Please bear with me. We celebrate the miracle of a small Jewish army defeating the world's greatest global power of the time. We celebrate the establishment of a prosperous self-ruling dynasty and the successful fight for Jewish autonomy and self-determination. We celebrate the religious right for Jews to exist as Jews, and that has been throughout history. This is the second temple. This temple was built after the first temple was destroyed. The temple was, if you're familiar with Jerusalem, where the gold dome is anybody familiar with that? The gold dome, that's where the first temple was built. And it was totally gone. It was totally eradicated. And David's son Solomon, I'm not going to say anything that you're not familiar with, built the second temple instead of the first temple. And this temple took 46 years to build. Now, there is a king, and his name is Antiochus. Could you say that? Antiochus. But I want to hear the ch. If you don't say the ch, it doesn't work. So, like, we believe in hearing your throat. You know how to do it. You can become Jewish in a minute. Just go. Israel was annexed into his empire. He forbade the Jews to follow their religion. He forbade them to do Shabbos, Shabbat, the seventh day. He forbade them to have circumcision, to pray. He didn't want them to do anything. He wanted them to pray to Zeus, which was a Greek god. The Jews refused. This is Antiochus fighting the Jews. Eventually, some of the Jews ran away, and Matityahu, who was a father of five sons, lived in the place called Modi'in in Israel. It wasn't Israel then, it was Judea. I'm saying the wrong thing. I apologize. Judah the Maccabee was one of Matityahu's sons. Next. And he revolted for 4 years against Antiochus' army. And when he finally finished the revolt and went to the temple, he found that it was totally destroyed. And inside were oil lamps. Now, these are pictures of ancient oil lamps that were found when people were archaeologically digging for all kinds of things in that area. And 7 of those oil lamps were desecrated, totally gone, and only one was left. And they wanted to light
this again with oil.
And when they lit it, they thought that the oil would last only for 1 day. Miraculously, the oil lasted for 8 days. And hence, we have now the Hanukkah.
This is considered
the new menorah. But in a temple today, if you go, you will still see the 6 with the 1, because that one is the one that belongs in the temple. This is only for your home. Everybody have a Hanukkah in the house? We light it either with candles or with oil. So the 8 days is to commemorate the miracle of the oil that it lasted for 8 days. Now, what is important about menorah to make it, so say, kosher? All the candles that are lit have to be the same height, and it have to last at least for a half hour. Now we light it from left to right, but when we put in a new candle, we put in on the right side, and we're going to light it from the new candle from right to left. So there is a sequence of the importance of the candles. But if you notice, this is an electric one. This really isn't kosher.
No.
I'm sorry. I don't even have an electric one in my house. I was never allowed to bring one in. Now, Hanukkah became well known as a holiday and the holiday of lights because of Christmas. It coincides with Christmas. Even though on a Jewish calendar, Hanukkah is on the 25th of Kislev and doesn't necessarily come at the same exact time every single year, because we go on a lunar calendar which changes according to the moon and the moon cycles and the sun cycles. But it can come any time from the end of November up to almost the end of December. Now the tradition that people think we got presents every 8 days, ha 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 ha. We never got presents every 8 days. We got one present, and that was it. And of course, it always happened when we went to our grandparents. We spoiled our kids by giving them 8 so they wouldn't feel bad about Christmas. Because I remember all the times I got the Christmas lights and the Christmas gifts and they did all this stuff. We wanted to feel a part of that too. So now we change the rituals to give them gifts every single night. We're also supposed to put the menorah in the window so we shine the light out on everybody and everybody can see it. Now the smell, oh, they can come in different shapes, by the way. You can have any kind of comical today menorah that you want. If you like baseball, they have them for the baseball teams, they have them for the football teams. So that is one, I think, for McDonald's, which isn't kosher, so I don't know about that so much. But you do have the other one. Okay, now, this is fun. This is called a dreidel. A dreidel in Yiddish means spin. We have 4 different letters on it. There is a fable, I'm not sure it is, that when they forbade the Jews to learn during the time of the temple and the army would come in, the men would quickly take the spinning top and make believe they're playing a game. This is Jewish poker.
Okay.
You can definitely play this instead of poker. It's much easier and faster and quicker. And you don't have to see everybody's eyes. You don't have to wear sunglasses and hide your face and all that other stuff that you do when you play poker. But let's go over it. We, the nun, which is the purple one here to the right, when you start the game, everybody puts into the pot. So let's say you put five in. I'll make it easier. Let's put an even number. Let's put four in. We put four pennies in. Today the children play with chocolate coins, which we're going to see a little later on, which is known as gelt. Gelt in Yiddish means money. You know what we used to do? We used to, did you ever see them, those old chocolate coins and the covers? And didn't you want to always take the cover off and take the chocolate out? We used to put them back together and tease our cousins. And when they opened it up, there wasn't any chocolate inside. They would get so angry. But it took us days to do that because it's not that easy to do. And they get crinkled and all kinds of stuff. But anyway, when you start the pot, now, if you spin it and it lands on the purple letter, which is the nun, you get nothing. That's it, you lose your turn. Go to the gimel. Gimel is, these are also letters in the Jewish alphabet. In the Hebrew alphabet, I should say. Wrong word. The gimel stands for ganz. This is all Yiddish, meaning everything. So you take the whole pot. Nice, right? Now there's nothing in the middle anymore. So everybody has to put in again something. No. Now hey, the red one, stands for half. Half of whatever in the pot is what you get.
Okay.
And shin
no.
means you have to put it in. So now it's your turn to put in something into the pot. Now what do you want to play dreidel here? And see who won? I know that Ricardo wants to. It's a fun game. My father used to sit with all of us when we would get together for Hanukkah with all the little cousins. And he used to do superhero sounds and noises, and he would make believe he was the Hanukkah superhero, and the kids would turn the dreidel, and he would carry on with them. It was lots of fun. It was tons of fun. This is what we're fighting over. The geld, the money. Till today, we still play games for money. You're 50-50. You know? Come on. It's all about the money. But these are the chocolate coins that have become very popular with the children. And this is what we live for.
We're here for it.
The smells of the latkes.
Hungry.
And also, the jelly donuts in Hebrew is called sufganiyot. They are so good if they're made in a kosher Jewish bakery. Not talking about kosher bakery, Jewish bakery. They are the best, absolute best. You can't compare them to any other kind of donut. You really can't. Now, why do we serve fried food and fattening food? Not that we're big, you know, we're big enough to begin with, but because the holiday revolves around the oil. So anything fried is what we're going to try and eat. And of course, we all gather around, we light the candles together as a family, we say our prayers, we have a good time, we hang out, and we just have plain fun. This is a fun holiday. So family oriented for good things, for gifts. Don't make yourselves crazy. One night, I just Venmoed my grandkids' money. That was it. I said, leave me alone, just Venmoing you. And I get a love star back. What else would I get, right?
Yeah. Do 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 bum 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 do 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 bum bum bum
candles were lighting on Hanukkah. Blessings reciting on Hanukkah. Fried foods were biting on Hanukkah. Family uniting on Hanukkah. I made a clay dreidel to spin. Why does it only land on shin? Sufganiyot with my family. I'll take a latke if you please. Chocolate mommy on Hanukkah, latkes are crunchy on Hanukkah, presents from Bobby on Hanukkah, I want a puppy for Hanukkah. Gather around the menorah and light each candle's flame while proudly we proclaim we're free.
Menorah, recall the great temple's menorah
and how the oil they found kept burning strong and proud brightly. Menorah,
watch the flames as they're dancing, swaying. Feel the joy of the blessings we're saying.
Menorah, with eight lights, it's called Hanukkah.
Dear mighty Antiochus, you gotta understand.
Boys and kids are toothless, can't get out of our land.
The soldiers smashed our temple, and all our oil is bad.
Goodness gracious, now you made us mad.
G King Antiochus, you're really obtuse. You'll never get us worshipping Apollo or Zeus. We don't bow to idols, you're made out of wood.
This polytheism's no good.
It's no good,
it's no good.
It's no good, no, it's just no good. All this polytheism's no good.
Eight nights, we celebrate God's might and Maccabees for saving the day.
Eight nights, a festival of lights. We give thanks that we've lived to this day. Celebration for miracles that happen, the victories and the light.
Now here we are, our hearts and candles shining like stars.
$5 in January. At first, I'd like to thank Art for helping
enjoy tonight.
One candle for those who are suffering, the pain we learned so long ago. Come on.